iniquity, and I will seize the arrogancy of the proud to seize, and will lay low the haughtiness of the terrible. That's right, man. The people are proud, man. Proud for no reason. That's why the Lord says, why is earth and ash is proud? But people are proud for no apparent reason. No. I want to get one more precept to back up, right? Before I get into the emotions, okay? Second Peter, right? Second Peter 2. That's one. 2 Peter 2. And where are we going to go? Is it 10? 2 Peter 3 and 12. It says, but the day of the Lord. No, I'm going to start at verse 9. It says, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as men count slackness, but is long suffering towards us, were not willing that should perish, but that we all should come to repentance. Okay? And that's what? That's what we mainly are to tell our people, okay? So called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, warning them of the things of what's to come, and tell them what? Look, repent. Okay, you want to get saved out here from this nuclear destruction, okay, turn back to the Heavenly Father, okay? If you want to be possible to save your kids, okay, or your household, okay, because they all come up under the man, you need to repent, okay, and come back to the Heavenly Father and the Son. You know, that's the mainly the whole message. But what? Only the elect is going to take heed. Okay? It says, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. Okay, so what is so powerful that can melt elements? Okay, what can melt this stop sign? Okay, melt these buses, melt these cars, melt these houses, all these buildings, these bricks. Okay, what is so powerful that can do that? Okay, the nuclear missiles. Okay. That's why they were created by the Heavenly Father and Son for what? Because the earth needed cleansing. Okay? The earth needs. The earth needs a physical cleansing and a spiritual cleansing. Okay? Because what? This place is polluted. This place is polluted on all aspects. Okay? And what? Fire is what? A cleansing agent, okay? Just like well as water, okay? Water is also a cleansing agent. You know, but what? Everybody knows that what? They already know the flood happened, so they know the Heavenly Father says what? He's going to come back in fire. They don't know how it's going to happen, you know, but a lot of people just quote it. But we, in the scripture, we know how it's going to happen, okay? You know? But it says, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat, and the earth also and the works therein shall be burnt up. Okay, that's right. Okay, that's what I was going into, okay? The heavens shall be rolled as a scroll, okay? And I said what? This place is going to be a desolate wilderness for desert-like creatures. What's going to make that happen? The missiles. Okay? Let's get that, man. Isaiah 34. I'll start at the top. Okay? 34 and 1. It says, come near ye nations, hear and hearken ye people, let the earth hear all that therein the world and all the things that come forth of it. Okay? It says, for the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations. Okay? And what is that? Okay, you look into the word indignation. That's righteous anger. Okay? Only one that can have righteous anger. Okay? And be justified in all his works that he does. Because what? He is the creator. So for the indignation of the Lord is upon all nations, and his fury upon all their armies. He has utterly destroyed them. He has delivered them to the slaughter. Okay? Since their slain also shall be cast out, and their stink shall come up of their carcass, and the mountains shall be melted with their blood. And all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll. And how is that able to happen, okay? When the missile hits this place, okay? The flames is going to rise up, okay? The smoke, it's going to be like a scroll. It's going to roll as a scroll, okay? It says, and all the host shall fall down as a leaf falling from a vine, and as a falling fig from the fig tree. It says, for my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea and upon the people of my curse, and upon my curse to judgment. Okay, now who is the people of Idumea to upon the curse and the judgment of the Heavenly Father? Okay, the Greek way of saying Idumea is Edom. Okay, and when you go into the nationality of Edom, according to the Bible, okay, you can't see it because it's so light out here, okay? Edom is Esau, okay? The so-called white man, okay? You are the Edomite, according to the Bible, okay? In the script, in the Bible, no one's black, okay? No one's white, okay? Johann and Blumenbach came up with that people by colors, man. But that's not the case. Everybody, according to the Bible, has a nationality. Okay? It says, verse 6, it says, the sword of the Lord is filled with blood, and is made fat with the fatness and the blood of lambs and goats, with the fat of kidneys of rams. For the Lord have a sacrifice of Bozrah and a great slaughter in the land of Idumea, okay? So that's wherever you Edomites dwell at, okay? That's where the sword is going to be bathed at, okay? And you know Bozrah is what? An Edomite city, okay? It says, and the unicorn shall come down with them, and the bullocks with the bulls, and the land shall be soaked with blood, and their dust made fat with fat. That's right, okay? That's saying when you go into scriptures, it says, who is that coming from Bozrah with the garment on? Okay, that's who the world and he called Jesus Christ, okay? That's a metaphor to what? How much killing is going to be upon his land when he comes back, okay? It says, for the day of the Lord's vengeance and the year of his recompenses for the controversy of Zion. Okay, that's right. Who are Zion, okay? So-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, okay? What? You know, Puerto Ricans, Mexicans, Seminole Indians, Native American Indians, Cubans, Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, Haitians, West Indians, you know, so-called Negroes, Guatemalans, the Panamanians, okay, Argentinians, Chileans, okay, the Colombians, the Uruguayans, any of you of the Negro and Indian descent, you are considered Zion, okay? And the Lord said he's what has controversy with the nations. Why? Because they all have put their hands on the children of Israel. Each and every nation, okay? All the nations that you see on the table of nations have parts to do with the children of Israel, okay? But the chiefest out of them all, who's going to get the worst of the Lord's judgment, is Esau, okay, the so-called white man, That's why he doesn't want to beat Esau according to the Bible, okay? Because Esau is going to get a harsh judgment, okay? The harshest judgment out of all the nations, okay? Only one that's going to get it after his 1,000 years of slavery is going to be cast off the earth, okay? Because whether you believe it or like it or not, all you other nations are going in slavery under the Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. Because what? We are up next to rule, okay? We are going to rule in the kingdom of heaven, okay? Which will be on earth, okay? It will be changes of rulership, okay? Also, just want to put that out there. There is not no place called hell, okay? You don't go to hell and burn forever, okay? That's Roman Catholicism, okay? Hell is a condition, okay? You go into the Greek word hell, means Hades, okay? Which means grave, or it means a condition, okay? What? The Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, they are in hell, okay? We are in hell, okay? The so-called white man, Edom, or Edomites, I should say, the so-called white people, y'all in heaven right now, okay? And that's that. Alright, so back at this, Isaiah 34:8, it says, where did the devil hold vengeance? There are recompenses for the controversy of Zion, and the strange thereof shall be turned into pitch, and the dust thereof into brimstone, and the land of thereof shall become burning pitch, and it shall not be quenched, night nor day. Smoke thereof shall go up forever, from generation to generation shall lie waste, and none shall pass through it forever and ever. Said the cormorant and the bittern shall possess it, the owl also and the raven shall dwell in it, and he shall stretch out upon it the line of confusion and the stones of emptiness. That's right, okay? There's not going to be no more street signs, okay? No more statues of Andrew Jackson, okay? The Indian killer, wherever he is down here in Florida, okay? No more statues of George Washington, D.C., okay? All these raping, robbing, and murderers upon this land, okay? We're not gonna know where New York City was, okay? Because this place is gonna be burnt up, it's gonna be a desert. Says they shall call the nobles throughout the kingdom, but none shall be there, all the victims shall be nothing. Let's let all this fire go past first, okay? Of the desert shall also meet with the wild beast of the island, and of the satyr shall cry his fellow, and the shush owl also shall rest there and find for himself a place of rest. So there shall the great owl make her nest. Shall the great owl make her nest and lay hatch and gather under the shadow? There shall the vultures also be gathered, everyone with their mates. That's right. When you look up into them type of birds and things like that, you know, them are all desert-like creatures, okay? And what? That place where they're going to be dwelling at is what? America, okay? America is Babylon the Great, okay? The mother of harlots in the scriptures. Okay. Hey, so basically that's what? That's America's judgment in the scriptures, okay? Because, you know, this place is at an all-time high wickedness, and it has to be judged, man. It has to happen, man. Lord willing, I hope it's very soon, you know? Be honest, you know, I hope the kingdom was to come tomorrow, you know? Everybody's trying to keep going through this wickedness and this sickness, seeing all these different things going on, man. This place is vexing, man. You know, to the true men of the Lord, okay? Not you fake hypocrite Christians out there, man. You know? Y'all just speak good game, man. You know? But, hey, y'all gonna be dealt with real soon as well, too. You know? Let's jump to, back at Isaiah 13. 13, right? It says, therefore I will shake the heavens and the earth, and shall remove out of her place in the wrath for the Lord of hosts in the day of her fierce anger, and it shall be as the chaste roe, and as a sheep that no man taketh up they, shall every man turn to his own people, and flee everyone to his own land. That's right, so all you other nations that came to live off the land, okay, to come off to eat off America, you know, that's going into some, okay, you so-called Chinese, okay, East Indians, Arabs, okay, Japanese, okay, so-called what, Africans, all you other nations, all you ones that live deliciously here, okay, when you find out this place is about to go, which a lot of them are starting to know the fact of it, you're going to run and flee to your own land, because you're going to know what? There's going to be no more money made here, okay? Because what? The economy is collapsing, and the dollar is devaluing tremendously, okay? As we speak, the dollar is decreasing value, okay? Verse 15, says, everyone that is found shall be thrust through, and everyone that is joined unto them shall fall by the sword. There shall the children also shall be dashed to pieces before their eyes. Their houses shall be spoiled, and their wives ravaged. Hey, like I was going in before, I said it's going to be like a time no one ever experienced, okay? You know, you think when these UN troops come over here, you think they're going to have mercy on the people of America? No. That's why they got UN troops, okay? Because the average American person in the army, they're not going to want to do it. So for the UN troop, a troop will, okay? They don't mind. No? What? It says what? Houses spoiled, okay? Houses is going to be spoiled, okay? That means it's going to be taken over. It says women ravaged, okay? When it says women ravaged, that means women being raped, okay? Now here it is in Venezuela. You got no, all the cops took off, right? Come on, man. You know that women are over there getting ravished over there. If there's no cops, you can't call on no cops. Come on, man. All hell's gonna break loose when there's no cops gonna be out here. Where the cops gonna be? They're gonna be trying to protect their family, okay? People are gonna pick up the phone, trying to call 911. Phone's gonna be off the hook. It's gonna be busy, okay? Or it's gonna keep ringing. Cause what? Cops are not gonna wanna defend people when they gotta protect their family, or if they're not getting paid, they're not gonna do it. Hey, so what? Extreme measures is gonna happen out here to you people, man. It says verse 17. It says, behold, I will stir up the Medes against them, which shall not regard silver and as for gold, they shall not delight in it. That's right, okay? That's talking about the Russians, okay? Because the Russians are going to be the main ones that's going to shoot nukes over here, man. Soon as America set foot in soil, lay ground troops in Iran, hey, all bets is off, man. Because who's backing up Iran? Russia. And who's backing up Russia? China, okay? So all these different nations is backing up each other. You know, so now what? America know better not to mess with these other countries, okay? Because I already went into it before. Let the weak say I'm strong, okay? So all these weak nations are now with a nuclear capability more strong as the other nations, okay? And when you read, verse 18, it says, their bows also shall dash the young men to pieces, and they shall have no pity on the fruit of the womb, and their eyes shall not spare children. That's right, man. Even at a time of war, when you go to war with another country, you don't pity people's nation and their children, man. You just ultimately, what? You go destroy, okay? And that's going to happen on the shores of America, man. Ain't no 20 years in America, man. Ain't no 15 years here in America, man. No. The least, and I'm just estimating the least, I give it 3. Hopefully it's not even that, okay? Because once the Heavenly Father got all these different prophecies end up coming to pass, you know, once the elect is sealed, the 144,000 from the nation of Israel, all bets is off, man. You know, once this gospel is preached out to the whole kingdom, all bets is off, okay? Let's get that. All bets is off, man. Matthew 24, Matthew 24:14, it says, you know what, let's start at the top, Matthew 24:3, okay, because the disciples asked the Lord and said, what is the signs and thy coming of thy time? Okay. What's the end of the world? Okay. And when it says the end of the world in the scriptures, okay, at Matthew 24:3, that's speaking of what? Age or rulership, okay? It's not talking about the end of the whole world. Okay. It says in Matthew 24:3, and he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately saying, tell us, when shall these things be, and what shall be the sign of thy coming in the end of the world? And Yahweh shall answer and said unto them, take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am the Mashiach, and shall deceive many. And you shall hear wars, and you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, okay? And that's what we're hearing now, okay? Cut on your alternative media. You're hearing of the rumors of wars. You're hearing of wars, the little wars that's going back and forth with Turkey and in different places, Russia, and a thing that's going on in the Middle East, okay? That's what you're hearing of, you know? And you go in and find out that what? NATO is bringing more troops close to the Russian border. Okay. And what? Russia, you know, setting up their anti-defense defense systems on all their borders. Okay? You know? And it says, see that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise up against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines, pestilence, earthquakes in diverse places. That's right, okay? I just spoke when I said what? There's going to be famines in the soils of America, okay? You know, you got earthquakes about a boatload, okay? All types of places, okay? Low magnitudes, very high magnitudes, but there's so much of them that they won't even release how many that's actually happening, okay? There was one time that I looked it up, right? It's like a little earthquake system, tell you how many earthquakes there was. Hey, there was 30 earthquakes in one day. And I'm not talking about little tremors neither. I'm talking about medium and high magnitude earthquakes, man. You know? What? Yeah, nation against nation, the kingdom against the kingdom. Because what? You know? That's what you see happening right now. These nations are rising up against each other. And also what? The race wars, okay? The race wars are inevitable, okay? No matter how many people, if you don't like it or not, race wars are going to happen, okay? Especially that you people are on that Trump juice, okay? You Edomites, okay? You know, you think you got Trump in office, now you think y'all want to be extra proud, but you're already proud, you know? You think that he's going to do something for you. Trump can't stop the race wars. Trump can't stop these nuclear missiles, okay? Verse 8, it says, all these are the beginning of sorrow. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. And then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. What's going on, brother? And it says, and many false prophets shall rise and deceive many. That's right, okay? All them false prophets, okay? All them false prophets in them churches, okay? Telling you there's going to be peace and peace. When the Heavenly Father said there won't be no peace coming here, okay? So what? You are considered a false prophet, okay? Let me see if I can find that real quick. Real quick. Jeremiah 6:14, it says, they have held also the hurt of the daughter of my people slightly, saying, peace, peace, when there is no peace. Okay, that's right, man. The Heavenly Father said there is no peace, man. There is no peace coming to the soils of America, you know. So what? That's those false prophets that are deceiving many, you know. Don't listen to them guys on the streets preaching on the corners. You know, there's no race wars coming. There is no World War III coming. Okay? The microchip is not the mark of the beast. Okay, all these different things. Okay? But that's why they are the false prophets, okay? Y'all are like sheep being led to the slaughter. Okay? Verse 12, back in that Matthew 24, it says, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. But he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. That's right. I just went into that earlier. I said, people say, oh, we go to church, they come out and say, oh, we're saved. You know? Hey, I remember one time my aunt called me, you know, and she said, oh, so I heard you reading the Bible a lot. I'm like, yeah. Like, I heard you into the Bible. I'm like, yeah, you know. She's like, so are you saved yet? I'm laughing on the phone, but I'm like, no. You know, but since I've been a little bit rooted in this truth for a while, I've known and said, you know what? I'm not even going to go into it with her. You know what I mean? Because I was about to go into it with her, like, how are you saved? You know what I mean? But I knew it was going to stir up all this competition, so I said, you know what? Whatever, man. I'm going to let you have it, man. But in my head, I'm like, people really think they're saved. From what? Okay, what are you saved from? Didn't no destruction or no affliction come upon this land yet. So what are you saved from? Okay? Read that again. Matthew 24:13 says, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. So you gotta endure to the end, okay? You gotta endure until all these things come upon you and that you be delivered out of it, okay? Meaning what? You got to be beamed up by the chariots, okay? When you're in the windows of the chariots looking down at America being destroyed, that's how you're going to know you're going to be saved. That's why it says, what it say? The righteous, I think, scarcely shall be saved, okay? Because no one knows, no one knows if they're the elect or not, okay? So that's how, you're going to be scarce of being saved, okay? See if I can find that. That's what it is, man, you know? It's about the truth, okay? It's not about coming out here, you know, by my opinion, coming out here with this weak, passive spirit. Hey, that's not how we coming. That's not the time we in, man. We're in a time of destruction right now. Second Ezra 6 and 25 says, I'm going to start at 23. It says, and a trumpet shall give a sound, which when every man heareth, they shall suddenly be afraid. Okay? That's the seventh trumpet. Okay? It says, at the time shall friends fight one against another like enemies, and the earth shall stand in fear with those that dwell therein. The springs of the fountains shall sound. Springs of the fountains shall stand still. In 3 hours they shall not run. Whosoever remaineth from all these that I have told thee shall escape and see my salvation and the end of your world. That's right, okay? Who shall escape the salvation? I mean, who shall escape? They shall see the salvation, okay? They are who endure into the end, okay? You know? You got all of these people out here that think they're saved, man. You know? Hey, your false prophet pastors